Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So in the previous session we have discussed about introduction part of chemical kinetics, and when we considered rate of a reaction, we defined it, and we considered types of a rate of a reaction, that is average rate and instantaneous rate, and even we considered about expressing how we are going to express the rate of a reaction. And regarding measurement of that instantaneous rate, we consider graphs, CT graphs, concentration versus time graph, by which it is possible to measure the instantaneous rate. So there we come across basically how average and instantaneous rate differs from one another. Okay, average rate refers to which is measured, the rate measured over a long interval of time, or I can say even per unit time. Instantaneous refers to the rate measured over a particular instant of time. Well, so in this session we discuss about some other concept, like say rate of a reaction and a stoichiometry of a reaction. So usually when I consider balanced chemical equation, what type of reaction? It must be a balanced chemical equation. So for a balanced chemical equation, one can specify its stoichiometry. Well, what is stoichiometry? It specifies the number of moles of reactants and products. It indicates the ratio of number of moles of reactants and products involved in a balanced chemical equation. So it gives the stoichiometry. So there is a relation between rate of a reaction and a stoichiometry of a reaction. So here, stoichiometry of a reaction may be 1:1, or it may be other than 1:1 also. So now first we deal with a general reaction, so for which its stoichiometry is 1:1. So a general reaction, A plus B gives rise to P plus Q. Here A and B are the reactants, P and Q are the product. What is the stoichiometric coefficient of all these quantities? 1:1:1:1. So overall I can say stoichiometry of this general equation is 1:1. In such case, for any reaction, for any balanced chemical equation, if its stoichiometry is 1:1, what it says, which indicates that rate of decrease in the concentration of reactant, we know that concentration of reactant goes on decreases. In that case, rate of decrease in the concentration of reactant is equal to the rate of increase in the concentration of a product. As we said, rate of a reaction can be expressed by using any of the reactant or product with respect to time. Well, it is possible only when its stoichiometry is 1:1. So what I am saying, if the stoichiometry of the reaction is 1:1, in such case only rate of decrease in the concentration of reactants will be equal to rate of increase in the concentration of a product. So in that case, what I can say, rate of reaction, so in this particular example, minus dA by dt is equal to minus dB by dt is equal to plus dP by dt, which is equal to plus dQ by dt. It means rate of a reaction can be expressed by using any of the reactant or any of the product. All quantities gives rate of a reaction itself, means all these quantities are equal. Mathematically, when you go for measuring, calculating the rate by using different quantities, in all the case we get the same value for rate of a reaction. When it is? When the stoichiometry of the reaction is 1:1. Well, if the stoichiometry of the reaction is not 1:1, in such case, rate is different with respect to reactants and products. Well, that we come across now. Say for 1:1 stoichiometry, one example, say calcium carbonate gives rise to calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. What is the stoichiometry? 1:1:1. That is 1 mole of calcium carbonate on thermal decomposition gives 1 mole of calcium oxide and 1 mole of carbon dioxide. Here stoichiometry of the given reaction is 1:1 itself. Therefore, in this case, If I want to express the rate can be expressed by considering calcium carbonate, or else rate of a reaction can also be expressed by considering calcium oxide and even carbon dioxide. Therefore, I can say overall rate of a reaction is equal to minus D of CaCO3 by dt, change in the concentration of calcium carbonate, or I can say decrease in the concentration of calcium carbonate by time taken, plus D of calcium oxide by dt, or plus D of CO2 by dt. So overall, if it is 1:1, stoichiometry of a reaction is 1:1, yes, we can express the rate by considering any of the reactant or product. Well, but the actual problem is what I said, if 1:1 stoichiometry doesn't exist, if the reaction do not have 1:1 stoichiometric ratio. So in case of reactions where 1:1 stoichiometric relation does not exist, such a reaction derivatives with respect to reactants and products will not have the same rate. If 1:1 stoichiometry doesn't exist, then whatever the derivatives we get, they are going to give different value for a rate of a reaction. In the sense, we are going to get different rate values for a same reaction. Well, in such case, say for example, a reaction, it is a balanced equation, N2 plus 3H2 gives rise to 2NH3, that is formation of ammonia in presence of iron. When you look at the stoichiometric ratio of this reaction, what is the ratio? 1:3:2, that is 1 mole of nitrogen combines with the 3 moles of hydrogen gives rise to 2 moles of ammonia. So what is the stoichiometry of this reaction? 1:3:2 is the stoichiometry of a reaction. Well, according to the stoichiometry and definition of rate of a reaction, if I want to write rate here, so how we get? Say the rate at which hydrogen consumed, if I consider rate of reaction with respect to dihydrogen, what is the expression we get? Rate is equal to minus D of H2 by dt. But here, how many moles of hydrogen? 3 moles of hydrogen. So for the same interval of time, when 1 mole of nitrogen consumes, at the same time 3 moles of hydrogen will be consumed. Okay, so quantity of hydrogen consumption is more compared to nitrogen. Say what I am saying, the rate at which hydrogen consumed is 3 times faster than the rate of consumption of nitrogen. When you look at the stoichiometry 1:3, when 1 mole of nitrogen consumes, at the same time 3 moles of hydrogen will be consumed, reacted. So we say rate of consumption of hydrogen is 3 times faster than the rate of consumption of nitrogen. So both are different here. Rate of consumption of nitrogen is not equal to rate of consumption of hydrogen. So we are going to get differences. Further, when you look at the product formation, at the same interval of time, 2 moles of ammonia will be formed. Means when I look at the rate of formation of ammonia, what it says? The rate of formation of ammonia is two times the rate of consumption of nitrogen. Once again, when I look at the three rate quantities, all three are different from one another. So if I want to express it mathematically, what it would be? So rate of reaction is equal to minus dN2 by dt is not equal to minus dH2 by dt, which is not equal to dNH3 by dt. Since, as I said here, rate of consumption of hydrogen is 3 times the rate of consumption of nitrogen. Further, rate of formation of ammonia is twice the rate of consumption of nitrogen. So all these three quantities are not equal. Means that a definition holds good only for a reaction having 1:1 stoichiometry. So we come across some difficulty here. To overcome this difficulty, what they have done is, so in order to have unique values of reaction rates, all these quantities must be equal. To make it equal, that is, in order to have unique values of reaction rate in such cases. What we are doing? The derivatives of reactants and product are divided by their respective stoichiometric coefficients from a balanced chemical equation. While expressing the rate, if 1:1 stoichiometry doesn't exist, how we are expressing the rate? Well, we are writing the derivatives with respect to reactant as well as product. Further, those derivatives are divided by respective stoichiometric coefficients, which are taken from balanced chemical equation. Is it clear? Well, in such case, what is the rate now? So rate is equal to minus dN2 by dt is equal to, what is the stoichiometric coefficient there? 3. So minus 1 by 3 d of H2 by dt is equal to, for ammonia, what is the stoichiometric coefficient? 2 is the stoichiometric coefficient. Therefore, 1 by 2 dNH3 by dt. Well, so please remember this. If 1:1 stoichiometry doesn't exist, what happens? Rate not becomes equal to all reactants and products. So in such case, what you have to do? All derivatives are divided by corresponding stoichiometric coefficients from a balanced chemical equation. Well, generally, for any general reaction of, say, A of A plus B of B gives rise to C of C plus D of D. Say, consider it is a balanced equation. AB, capital A and capital B reactants, corresponding stoichiometric coefficients, C and D product with respect to stoichiometric coefficients. Well, now if I want to express the rate of this balanced equation, so according to this modification, how I can express the rate? Rate is equal to minus 1 by A stoichiometric coefficient into its derivative dA by dt is equal to, it is a reactant, so negative sign, stoichiometric coefficient is small b, so 1 by b, so minus 1 by b dB by dt is equal to product, so positive sign, stoichiometric coefficient is small c, so 1 by c dc by dt is equal to, again one more product, so positive sign, small d, so 1 by d dD by dt. So it is to be remembered. Well, consider some examples. So for example, H2 plus O2 gives rise to 2H2O, formation of a water molecule. Now, what is the stoichiometry of the reaction here? 2:1:2. So according to that concept, what I can say, rate is equal to minus 1 by 2 dH2 by dt is equal to minus 1 DO2 by dt is equal to plus 1 by 2 d of H2O by dt. So stoichiometric coefficients 2:1:2. So accordingly we are expressing the rate. All derivatives are divided by their respective stoichiometric coefficients. Similarly, H2 plus Cl2 gives rise to 2HCl. What is the stoichiometry here? 1:1:2. 1 mole of hydrogen gas combines with 1 mole of chlorine gas gives rise to 2 moles of HCl in presence of sunlight. Well, here, how I can express the rate? Rate is equal to minus dH2 by dt, since 1 is the stoichiometric coefficient, minus dCl2 by dt is equal to plus 1 by 2. Stoichiometric coefficient is 2, therefore, by 2 d of HCl by dt. Well, look at some other examples. 2H2O, H2O2, that is hydrogen peroxide, decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. 2H2O2 gives rise to 2H2O plus O2. So it's also balanced equation. Now look at the stoichiometry. 2:2:1. Then rate is equal to minus 1 by 2 d of H2O2 by dt is equal to product plus 1 by 2 dH2O by dt is equal to plus 1 is the stoichiometric coefficient. So no need to mention that. So plus DO2 by dt. Similarly, decomposition of dinitrogen pentoxide. 2N2O5 gives rise to 4NO2 plus O2. So what is the stoichiometry here? 2:4:1. Well, then rate minus 1 by 2 d of N2O5 by dt is equal to plus product. So plus 1 by 4 dNO2 by dt is equal to 1 is stoichiometry. So plus DO2 by dt. So as like, if the stoichiometric coefficient is not equal to 1:1, in such case, how rate is made equal with respect to all reactant and product means simply by dividing all derivatives with corresponding stoichiometric coefficients, which are taken from balanced chemical equation. Well, it's regarding relation between rate of a reaction and stoichiometry of a reaction. Well, here if I want to consider gaseous reactions, well, in case of gaseous reactions, how we are going to express the rate means rate is expressed by using the change in the partial pressure of a gases. As like here I considered, for any other than gaseous reactions, their concentrations are considered as a molar concentrations. In case of gaseous reactions, their concentrations are expressed in terms of partial pressures. Okay, well, now coming to the expressing the rate of a reaction. So generally I said rate of a reaction can be expressed either in the form of reactants or products. In general, generally how we are going to express the rate of a reaction means, say for DC, that D I already mentioned, small change, DC concentration. So a small change in the concentration of any of the reactant or product during a small interval of time dt. DC is the small change in the concentration of any of the reactant or product in a small interval of time dt. Then according to the definition, what it says, rate is nothing but the ratio of those two quantities, DC by dt. Well, I said a rate can be expressed with respect to reactant as well as product. Say if rate of a reaction is expressed in terms of any of the reactant. Reactant means, we already mentioned, whose concentration goes on decreases. That a decrease in the concentration can be expressed by making sign convention. What is that? Negative sign. So I can say rate of reaction is equal to minus DC by DT. So remember, if rate of reaction is expressed in terms of any of the reactant, then rate will be minus DC by DT. I already mentioned purpose of this taking minus sign. Well, second thing, the rate of a reaction can also be expressed by taking any of the product. Well, in that case, the rate becomes equal to plus DC by DT. So with respect to reactants, minus DC by DT. With respect to product, plus DC by DT. So in generally how I can express rate of a reaction is equal to plus or minus DC by DT. Okay. So it's regarding expressing the rate of a reaction. So we have two kinds. Rate of a reaction can be expressed as minus DC by DT or plus DC by DT. With respect to reactants, minus DC by DT. With respect to product, plus DC by DT. So overall, how we are going to express the rate? It is either plus or minus DC by DT. So it is regarding expressing the rate of a reaction. Then coming to the unit of rate of a reaction. Unit for rate of a reaction. Well, here rate of a reaction, DC already mentioned, change in the concentration, that DC refers to. Don't consider the signs here. Well, just consider only quantity, DC by DT. So DC refers to change in the concentration. Change in the concentration, that DT refers to time taken. We know that concentration is expressed in terms of molarity. So I say moles per dm cube, or I can say moles per liter, molar concentrations. And what about time? Usually time is measured in terms of second. So rate of a reaction is the ratio of change in the concentration of any of the reactant or product to the time taken. So concentration, moles per dm cube is the unit, time taken, second is the unit. So overall, if I consider rate, unit for rate of a reaction, what it is? Moles per dm cube second, or else dm cube can be considered as a liter, so moles per liter second. So remember the unit for rate of a reaction is moles per dm cube second, or else moles per liter second. Well, if there are gaseous species, I already mentioned their concentrations are expressed in terms of their partial pressures. Okay, as I said here, change in concentration. So in case of gaseous species, what we used to say, change in the partial pressure to the time taken. Well, how pressure is expressed? Pressure may be measured in terms of atmosphere, it may be measured in terms of bar, or it may be measured in terms of Pascal. So accordingly, what is the unit for gaseous species? If there are gaseous species, their unit will be atmosphere per second, bar per second, or Pascal per second. Change in the partial pressure, it may be atmosphere, it may be bar, or it may be Pascal. Time taken, second. So accordingly, for gaseous reactions, the respective unit for rate of reaction will be either atmosphere per second or bar per second or Pascal per second. So it's regarding unit of rate of a reaction. Well, I hope you understood all these concepts. In the next session, we discuss about some other concept of a chemical kinetics. Well, thank you.
Thanks for watching.
Like,
comments,
share,
and
subscribe.